Today, I'm going to show you the easiest way to replace a screen in DaVinci Resolve. And I'm going to show you two techniques, both in the Fusion page, but don't worry, you should be able to do this even if you're a beginner. And I'm also going to show you why I almost threw my computer out the window while making this tutorial. Yeah, it was bad. Frustrating. But first things first, if you're gonna film a screen yourself, like I did, so if you're not gonna use stock footage, you're gonna need a screen replacement tracking image. I don't know what it's called. It's these things, see? A lot of times they're green, but also white, and you can get them on stock footage websites, but I mean, why would you pay for something that you can easily make yourself? I made mine in Photoshop, just a white background, type a plus sign, copy it a few times and done. And then, of course, you should have that image full screen on the screen you want to film. Now, there are a number of reasons why someone would want to do a screen replacement, but usually it's because you can get better quality of whatever it is you want to put on the screen because there's no annoying reflections or moiré or whatever. And it also allows you to be more flexible and have more control because you can add things later if you want. Okay. But let me just show you how to replace a screen in DaVinci Resolve. And I'm going to show you two techniques. The first one is the simplest one, but you can only use it for a static shot, so when there's no camera movement. So this is our clip, and let's go to the Fusion page right away. Then with the media in node selected, add a merge node, and it will connect automatically in between the media in and out node. Then drop the clip of whatever it is that you want on the screen in the node area here, connect it to the merge node. There we go. Then select that clip or that node of the clip and hit Shift plus spacebar. Look for the corner positioner and add it. And now all you have to do is drag the corners in the correct position, like this, and done. Now, if the contrast or the colors or the sharpness or noise of what's on the screen doesn't match with the rest of the video, you can of course add some other nodes to correct that and to make it look more realistic. But I'll show you that in a bit. First, I want to show you the second technique, the technique that you can use for a moving shot, a handheld shot, for example, like this one. Okay, so again, in the Fusion page, with the media in node selected, hit Shift plus spacebar and look for the planar tracker. Add it, and then make sure that the playhead is here at the beginning of the clip, and draw a rectangle on the screen, like that. Doesn't have to be super accurate, just make sure that you include the plus signs, that's important. Then hit set, and start tracking. And now Resolve will track the movement of your handheld shot. Okay, and then once it's finished, drop the clip of whatever it is that you want on the screen. Connect it to the planar tracker and set the operation mode of the planar tracker. So make sure that it's selected. Set the operation mode to corner pin. And then again, like before, drag the corners to the correct position. And done. Not too difficult, right? And you know, you could even add some motion graphics or some animated titles from Motion VFX, for example. And what do you know? What a coincidence. They're sponsoring this video. No, look, seriously, ever since I started this channel, I've only been using plugins, animated titles, and motion graphics from Motion VFX for all my videos. I love them. Not only because everything they offer looks super cool, just check out their latest editions, for example, M-Style Cinematic, a cinematic toolkit, and then M-Review, everything you need for your tech review channel. But I also love that everything is easy to use. Plug and play, drag and drop. And on top of that, you can easily customize everything by adjusting the settings. Go check them out, the link is in the description. Okay, and now let me show you how to make your screen replacement look more realistic. First, what if the screen replacement looks too sharp, for example? Well, just select it and add a blur node. But the problem here is, as you can see, the blur effect doesn't affect the edge of the screen replacement. See? But it should, of course, because otherwise it looks a bit weird. So what you need to do then is first set the amount of blur you want. Not too much, of course. I just want a tiny bit of blur. Then select the screen replacement clip and add a transform node. Scale it, make it smaller. See, and now you can see the edge is also being blurred. Let me make it more clear. If I go to the blur node again, make it stronger. See, and then all you have to do, let me set it back, is select the planar tracker node and reposition the corners so that it covers the screen. And in the same way, you can also add some grain. Hit Shift spacebar, look for grain and add it. And then just match the grain of the screen replacement with the grain of the other clip, of the surroundings, of the rest of the video. Or another example, let's say you want to put a horizontal video on a vertical screen, so the aspect ratio doesn't match. Well, just select the video, hit Shift plus spacebar and add a crop node. and then crop the image. In this case, it's useful to check this here, keep centered, and then when you're done, reposition the corners, and boom, done. But what if the colors or the contrast doesn't match? Well, I'm gonna show you, and this is where I almost went crazy. Like, it was so frustrating. Calm down. It's okay, I found a solution. I'm gonna show you. So select the screen replacement clip and add a color correction node, and then you can adjust the gain or the saturation, right? So far so good. But then when I tried adjusting the lift, for example, because I wanted to mute the blacks, and let me exaggerate it a bit now, see what happens? What is that? It does that weird thing here. Some kind of invisible mask that, like, I don't know. And I have absolutely no idea why it does that when I adjust the lift, but not when I adjust the gain or the saturation. What the hell is that? And I didn't know how to fix it, so I started watching a bunch of YouTube tutorials. You know what? In most of those tutorials, they only adjusted the saturation or the gain, not the lift. So I was like, yeah, great, now what? So none of those tutorials showed me how to adjust lift or brightness or contrast even, without getting that weird effect, that mask or whatever. But then, after spending an entire Sunday morning gulping buckets of coffee and getting all frustrated, I finally found a solution, and it was super simple. Here it is. All you need to do is select the color correction node, then add a rectangle, and then set the width and the height of that rectangle to 1, and boom. And I have no idea why this works, but sometimes, I guess, you don't need to know. It works, so yeah. But if one of you can tell me why that happens, you know, why it does that weird thing with that mask and it looks all weird, tell me, because I do wanna know. Let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.